Today, I will be reviewing the Logitech M570 mouse with the trackball. And this is the most reviewed mouse on Amazon, so let's see if it's worth it. Let's get into it. About a year and a half ago, I got a job as a receptionist and also created content on YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram. So during the day, I would be on the computer a lot at my job, and then after work, I would be creating content, editing my videos, making TikTok videos, and creating content on all social media. So 6 months into my job and creating content, I started to get quite a lot of pain in my thumb right here and a lot of cramps in my palm and hands where I had to do exercises to help with the pain. After a couple months of this pain, I kind of started to freak out because it wasn't going away. And I was like, I'm in my mid-20s. There's no way I can get early signs of carpal tunnel. So what I did is I went on Amazon, typed in ergonomic mouse, and looked at the options. And to my surprise, they're quite affordable. They're around $30 Canadian. But the Logitech M570 wireless trackball really caught my eye because it was double the price of most of the mouses, but it had by far the most reviews on Amazon. So I researched it a little bit more, seemed like it was a good mouse, and bought it. Now it came with a AA battery, a wireless USB receiver for your computer or laptop, and of course the mouse. The battery that comes with this mouse is set to last about 18 months, which is quite a long time. I've had the mouse for about a year now and I haven't replaced the battery yet. Now let's talk about the trackball. So the trackball is designed to help you with your wrist and really eliminates any wrist movement. And because of that, you're actually able to work like anywhere seamlessly and comfortably, whether it's your table, your couch, or even your bed. With like a regular mouse, it may be a bit tedious to do work on a couch or your bed if you don't have a mouse pad. So this trackball actually comes out. At the very bottom, there's like this little hole right here. So if you push it out, it comes out. And the reason why I want to show you this is the dust. There is actually quite a bit of dust buildup. What you'll want to do is actually clean that. I started to learn about this a few months ago because my trackball started to get stuck a lot. It wouldn't move as nicely as it used to. So I really read into it. And that way, every couple of months, I should be cleaning this. So next to the trackball are these two buttons that will move forward or backwards on your webpage. I find the response time pretty quick. There's no slowness or any lag, but I personally don't use it. I rather just use my trackpad to do that type of motion because when I lay my hands on my mouse, it just is so comfortable that the buttons are kind of off to the side where it's a bit tedious and out of the way for me to really use them. So it's just faster and easier to use my left hand to go backwards or forwards on my trackpad. Now let's talk about the body of the mouse. So there's a whole science behind ergonomic mouses and it's designed to really help your whole forearm, not just like your palm. Because of the vertical design, it puts your elbow and shoulders in a certain way where it's comfortable for you, where you don't really find that you're stiff, you're not really putting strain on your muscle. I can say that ever since using the ergonomic mouse, a lot of the pain in my thumb right here and a lot of the cramping in my fingers have really gone away and I haven't had to do like any exercises to help with like my pain. That being said, the mouse really contours to my fingers. It has these like little grooves and edges in the mouse where when my hands just go on the mouse, it's just so nice, so relaxing, and I don't find that my fingers cramp up, my fingers aren't stressed, my fingers aren't having any pain after like hours of editing. So let's talk about some downsides to the Logitech M570 because there are a few and I don't think that it's really suitable for everyone. First is it is ugly. Like it is not nice, it is not cute. It's big as well. It's like the size of my hands right here. It's pretty thick also. And no matter how I like set up my table or desk, this mouse will just stand out and not really match with my aesthetic. And that's the one downside is like if I ever want to do a desk tour, it's just not the nicest. However, for the price point of $60 Canadian, it does do the job. But there are ergonomic mouses out there that are really visually appealing, really nice design to it, but they're a bit more pricier. So I can't complain too much. So another downside to this mouse is if you're into computer games. Now, I know this mouse is probably not really designed for computer games, but if you're ever wondering whether you want to use it for computer games as well, will it be good? And the answer is most likely no. So I'm not much of a computer gamer, but my boyfriend friend is, and he plays a lot of like shooting game where he needs to really aim, and he finds that it's not precise at all. It's really awkward and something you really need to get used to. And with that being said, with this trackball, because you can't move your wrist, there's only so much surface you can cover. So with one swipe, you cannot go from one end of your computer screen to the very end. It really will just go to like halfway or two-thirds. And he mentioned that if, let's say, you're trying to like save your wrist, if you get wrist pain when you play computer games, it's just better if you put in your controller. So the last downfall I noticed with the Logitech M570 is editing. So going back to my boyfriend's point about precision, I find that when I'm editing, I like to edit out like little breaths I have, and I find that it takes time to get precise. And although it takes away wrist movement and although it moves quickly, precision is one of its downfalls. And again, I've used it for a year now, I've gotten used to it, but in the beginning it was really, really awkward. It was really hard to get really precise and it took time to get used to it. And with that being said, I'm a beginner when it comes to like YouTube editing, creating content, so it's not much of a deal breaker for me. But for any of you guys out there who are editing more advanced than I am and need precision, like on Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro, and that's your job, this mouse might not be made for you. You may be able to get used to it, but it takes time. So is this Logitech M570 worth it? Well, I think it's worth it for like a certain type of people, and those people I think are for like if you're a beginner in content creation and you really want to like have that convenience of editing anywhere in little space or a lot of space, I think this mouse is perfect for you, because I love editing on my couch with this mouse. I love editing on my bed with this mouse. I really don't have to move my wrist or anything. It's all the work is done in the trackball. I think it's great for anyone who does admin work, whether you're at work or you work from home. It's great for that because it will get the job done. Also, anyone who's just casually at home and wants to prevent carpal tunnel, this mouse will do the job. I mean, it really helped with the pain I had. I don't really get the pain in my thumb anymore. I don't really get cramps anymore when I edit. I can literally edit with this mouse for like hours and not really get any pains. But I don't think it's worth it for anyone who's into computer games, because as my boyfriend mentioned, it really takes a long time. It's really awkward to get used to this and it's not that precise. I don't think it's worth it for anyone who's really advanced in editing, whether you're a videographer, you edit for a job. I don't think this mouse will really cut it. But for the price point of $60, and if you want to like prevent carpal tunnel and you do just average work on your computer just casually, then it will be worth it for you. So overall, personally, I think it was worth it for myself. It really fixed the problem I had, which was the early signs of carpal tunnel. After a couple months, a lot of the pain went away. I've been using it for a year, no issues with it really. But of course, do your research, see what mouse works for you if you're interested in the ergonomic mouse space. But anyways, that is it for me. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.